describe him to me. And Muslims, look at the description of your Rasul. And for some, this would be the first time you hear what your Prophet looked like. I saw a man of striking appearance. ظاهر الوضاء أبلج الوجه radiant face, حسن الخلق, beautifully created. لم تعبه السجلة, his belly wasn't protruding. ولم تزر به السعلة, nor was his head disproportionate and small. وسيم قسيم, proportionate and delicate, finely made, a specimen of a creation. في عينيه دعج, in his eyes there was a contrast. The dark was immensely dark, the white was excessively white. وفي أشفاره وطف, and his eyelashes were long. وفي صوته صهل, and in his voice was a natural echo. وفي عنقه سطع, and his neck was elegantly long. وفي لحيته كثاثة, his beard was full and thick. أزج أقرن, his eyebrows were arched, but they were not joint, it was separated. In summit, فعليه الوقار, when he was silent, dignity covered him. وإن تكلم سماه وعلاه البهاء, and when he spoke, it was audible and clear, almost commanding and overtaking. أجمل الناس وأبهاهم من بعيد, from afar, the most striking and outstanding in appearance. وأحسنهم وأجملهم من قريب, and when he came near, the best of them and the most handsome of them in closeness. حلو المنطق, so such an exalted and sweet level of logic, like when he used to speak, it was so coherently logical, it was smooth and easy to understand. فصل لا نزر ولا هزر, he was to the point, not excessive nor too short. كأن منطقه خرزات نظم يتحدرن, his logic, his utterances, his words were like jewels coming out of a necklace, calculated, polished, one after the other, it would flow magically. ربعة, he was medium in height, your eye didn't have to strain to look up at him, nor was it tedious to look down at him, he was a comfortable sight to look at. له رفقاء يحفون به, he had friends, the people that were with him, they were working around him to try to serve and protect him. إن قال سمعوا لقوله, when he used to say something, they used to hearken to what he used to say. وإن أمر تبادروا إلى أمره, when he commanded, they used to compete to fulfill the command. This is Muhammad Rasulullah. This is Muhammad Rasulullah. Anas ibn Malik says, he says, I came out one night, it was the full moon night. And I looked at the moon, and in the desert, understand, the moon is an awesome sight. It is smooth, it is radiant, it is clear, it is gentle compared to the scorching sun at which they are used to. So the moon was the epitome of beauty. So he says, I came out at a full moon night and I looked at the moon and I saw it, beautiful, handsome. So I said, let me go see if the moon is more handsome or my Prophet is more handsome. Let me see if that is more beautiful or the Prophet is more beautiful. So I went and I saw him standing afar. So I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon, and I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon, and I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon, and he said, Wallahi, he was more handsome than the moon in its entirety. That is just the look of your Rasul. Aisha radiallahu anha says, I was sewing with the needle, my needle dropped in the dark, I couldn't find it. I said, Ya Rasul, I can't find it. He moved his face close, and I swear, out of the radiance of his face, I found my needle. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was mind-bogglingly handsome, but his handsomeness was covered with waqar and jalal and hayba. The sahaba say, when we used to sit at his feet, two feelings conflicting would come on the heart. The first one, you wanted to look at him, you wanted to behold the majesty of his face, and when you wanted to look up, shyness used to overtake you, so you used to look down. Amr ibn al-As says, I sat with him many times, but if you ask me to describe his face, I can't describe it. I wouldn't be able to look up to him ijlalan wa ta'zeeman. I couldn't look up at him. And that is why he didn't have the problems that Yusuf alayhi salam had. Because it was difficult to penetrate the awe and the splendor of the Rasul.